Hey sugar plums, welcome back to my channel. My name's Kenny. If you're new here, welcome. I hope you are all staying safe during this quarantine. I think everything is so crazy. I'm literally scared for my life, I'm not gonna lie. Right now I do have my health, so that's a plus, but a lot of people have been so struggling with social distancing themselves from other people. And this is something that I struggled with because I'm a social butterfly. You guys already know that. So it's been really hard for me to kind of just sit inside like a homebody. And I figured a lot of other people are probably having this issue too. So I figured, why not share some tips with you guys on how to social distance yourself and still stay connected with your peers. So me and my friends, we've been doing wine nights via FaceTime. I'm gonna insert pictures here, but we've been doing wine nights FaceTime and it is so much fun. I've been connecting with literally so many people that I feel like I fell out of touch with, and I'm really happy. So as terrible as the quarantine is, I do feel like it's brought me a lot closer to people. And I love that. I feel like I've been talking to people that I haven't talked to in quite some time. So it's really awesome to finally like reconnect and just talk to people that I've missed talking to. So that's one thing I can say I am happy about, I guess. I'm not happy about the quarantine, obviously. Before you trolls try to come in the comments and shade me. But I am happy that I am talking to people that I miss talking to. Literally like finding videos to look at. We just really just gossip truthfully about just everything and like what's everyone up to in their lives and just everything. Like that's the first way to, I guess, stay connected even while you're social distancing yourself. Second thing is games for your iPhone. Like there's so many games. I've been playing Uno, I've been playing Scrabble, I've been playing so many games with a bunch of my friends, just like, you know, like the old times. And obviously if we can't do these things together, it makes sense, just do it online. So I really have been just trying to do things that I would do in person online, and obviously you still lack that like in-person connection kind of thing, but it's still fun and it's just as good. If you're worried about not being able to see your friends or not being able to do something, there's other ways to do that. So I've been loving online games. And the third thing I would say is to find binge stuff on Netflix, Hulu, Disney Plus. But here's the kicker. Binge watch shows with your friends and then you guys could all chat about it. Group messages or FaceTime, and it's like you're almost watching it all together, which you are watching it together. I mean, just in separate locations, but it's still fun. You still get to connect and you still get to talk about things that you would probably talk about like at work or at school or at a party or whatever. Like you're still able to do those things. So I've been really watching Elite lately on Netflix. I watched Love is Blind. I've watched On My Block. There's just so many shows that you could watch with your friends. And I know you guys are gonna kill me, but I've never actually watched the show Gossip Girl. And a lot of people were surprised by that. I'm even surprised by that because I feel like Gossip Girl was like totally something I would watch. And I haven't watched it, so that is the next show that I'm gonna start. And I'm really excited about that because why not? I feel like Gossip Girl is totally on brand for me and I feel like I need to learn it. Comment down below who you guys think my favorite character will be because I'm curious. A lot of people said that they think I would like Serena. So Serena, I'm gonna be looking out for you on the show. But yeah, I'm just really excited to finally start Gossip Girl. It's been a long time coming and I'm honestly embarrassed to say that I haven't watched it. Another way to stay connected with your peers, even though we are supposed to be social distancing, is utilizing your social media apps. Instagram, Twitter, you know, all those. TikTok. I don't even have a TikTok, but I see people using it. But anyways, if you have Instagram, why not go live and talk to people? I think that's so much fun. It's something that I've been trying to do a lot more lately. I think lives are so much fun. You get to interact with so many different people. And I've noticed a lot of, like, influencers and celebrities have been going live a lot more often lately, and I think it's another really good way to connect with people. Obviously, uploading YouTube videos and talking to you guys, like the way I'm talking to you guys right now, is another way to stay connected with your peers. There's just so many ways to stay connected with your peers because social distancing is actually really, really hard, and it's something I've been struggling with. And I'm honestly not sure how long we'll have to social distance, but I'm trying my best to social distance as much as I can. I haven't seen any friends, and one of my best friends is Ishmael literally lives in New York and is home because he's from like PA, but he's home now. And I've refused to hang out with him because he lives in New York. And I know like the virus was really bad there and I just don't want to catch it. So I've been like avoiding hanging out with him and I don't think he has it, but that's how serious I'm taking like social distancing. The only person that I'm actually hanging out with is like my boyfriend and like my brother. They're the only two people that I'm hanging out with right now because I'm just so scared to catch anything from him for this video. But I really enjoy the polls on Instagram. All the like polls, I've been getting tagged in so many of those polls or that, like those kind of things are so much fun. I think doing those with your friends are just so fun. You get to learn a lot more about your friends and you get to learn things that you didn't know that you thought you knew. So that's really fun. And I've been seeing a lot of like the push-up challenges. I've got nominated for a push-up challenge. I haven't done it yet. I know you have 24 hours to do that. So I probably have like an hour left. So I'm probably not gonna complete that one. But if I get nominated again for a push-up challenge, I'm gonna do it. I've just been really busy editing and, you know, work-related things, so I haven't been able to get on the ground and do 10 push-ups. I mean, I definitely could have, but I'm just lazy. The next way I would say is to just go for a walk, you know? If you have an animal or a pet or dog, walk your dog. Like, I truthfully, I'll own up to it, I did not walk my dog as much as I probably should have. But I've been trying to walk him a lot more just because I'm lonely and he needs exercises as he's getting older. He actually just turned 13 and a lot of you guys probably didn't even know I had a dog, but I do have a dog. His name's Patchy. He's a pit bull. I've had him since I was in 7th grade. He was originally living with my parents' home, but my parents got too busy and couldn't take care of him. So they were like, Kenny, can you take him? And I decided to take him. Yeah, so I'm with my dog now and I have a dog and I love him so much. He's so sweet, literally the sweetest dog ever. And it is making me really sad that he is getting older because I feel like the older he gets, the less time with him I have. And he's 13 and pit bulls normally don't live past 15. They can die from anywhere from like 11 to 15 years. So he's like smack dab in the middle. And I'm really sad. So I've been trying to spend as much time with my dog as I can. We've been sleeping together every night and I just love my dog so much. So if you're having a hard time social distancing, connect with your dogs more. Connect with your animals, especially if they're older, because you don't know how much longer they have. Another really cool way to social distance yourself is to honestly play with makeup. Challenge your friends to do similar makeup looks and you guys can all do them, take pictures, send them in group chat. You know, just have fun with that. There's just so many different ways, guys, that you can just like have fun and still stay connected. And honestly, I feel like this quarantine is gonna make a lot of us closer because let's be real, a lot of us took for granted going outside and just driving down the street and like going to the club and partying and doing all those things. We took it for granted. So now that we don't have, I think a lot more people will be appreciative of living, truthfully, because we're not, so we don't have to be like cooped up in this house. And by the way, guys, I got my results back. I'm not sick with anything, so that is awesome. I've been doing a lot of cleaning. Makeup has taken so much time, and I'm actually in the process of filming a video for that. Because makeup is just, it can be crazy. And I really, 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 really need to organize my makeup. So I really have just been trying to focus on that. Artsy things, there's just so many things to do. And I just really wanted to make this video to give you guys some different ideas on how you can social distance yourself. It's really not that hard. It is hard, don't get me wrong, but it's possible if you at least try to. My sleep schedule's been so all over the place and so crazy. I don't even know what to do anymore. But yeah, I think I gave you guys a bunch of ideas. So I guess I got one more idea for you. Do you know this person named Kenny? His last name's Screven. He's a really fun YouTuber and he posts a lot of content these days, even though he was a bit of a slacker in the past. I think you guys should watch a lot of his videos and binge watch him because he is so much fun and he's been posting a lot more lately. Okay, obviously I'm annoying. But anyways, yeah, thank you Sugar Plums for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Make sure you turn on all your post notifications on and give this video a thumbs up and subscribe because I love posting now. I really do enjoy posting on YouTube and I hope you guys enjoy seeing me on YouTube and I hope you enjoy my feelings and my thoughts and all those kind of things because I love you Sugar Plums so much and I'll see you in the next one and I hope you all stay safe during this crazy epidemic because it's getting real crazy, and I just hope you guys are all safe, honestly. But yeah, I love you boo so much, and I'll see you in the next one. Mwah.